Yes, hello there, this is Mila Gethra, or Amaranthus616, and I'm here with another video for you guys, and this time it's a mod video, another mod video for Vice City. I've done some before. This one is a request video. It is a request by somebody called Almost610, and he's very involved with this mod, and he thinks some more videos expanding on the mod would be a good idea. I've already done some old videos, but he thinks it's time for some new videos, so I thought, why not? Why not? Get the mod out there more, explain to people a bit more what you can do with the mod. This video is just going to run down the basics of how to install the mod, install a car packaged for the mod, install a car that's not packaged for the mod, install cars from other Grand Theft Auto games, and install cars downloaded from the internet that are originally supposed to be downloads for other Grand Theft Auto games. In case you haven't already guessed, this is a vehicle loader mod. It makes it easy to place vehicles into the game instead of having to download them and mess with the game's files. You don't touch any of the game's files. That's good. As you can see there, the first line adds new vehicles to the game without replacing old ones. That's the key, that's the core essence of the mod, really. You can add in a million vehicles if you want. I can't remember what the exact limit is to how many cars you can add, but it's pretty damn high. You'd be hard pushed to reach it. Which is good, really, because you don't have to go, oh god, do I download this one, do I download this car, I'm going to reach the limit. You don't have to worry about that. So yeah, this is where you download it from. And I've been following this mod for quite a while. As you can see, as I scroll down, there's my old post on the forums. So yeah, let's go up. And we need to download Maxo's vehicle loader 0.98B. Now this is the latest public release. Save. Maxo's vehicle loader. I downloaded it in a specific place. I've downloaded it in a specific place, sorry, just to show you guys what's in the game mod files. I won't re-download it, I've already downloaded it. And I've already extracted these into my directory, because that's what you do. You extract these files into your directory after you've extracted them from here. So we cancel that. Go to where you downloaded them, and you'll see in the MSS file folder the vmodflt. Now this you can just place into the already existing MSS file folder, or you can just drag the folder in and it will merge them together. MVL is an entirely new folder, and this is what it looks like in the directory, and this is what it looks like in the mod. Yeah, and vehicles is where you place your downloaded vehicles. Ignore the XML file in there for now, and ignore the XML file. We will cover XML files in a later video though, and as you can see, there are some XMLs there. You can leave these in your directory if you want to extract in your directory. You will need them, but you don't necessarily need them in your directory. I have them separate. I have the latest XML. That's where all my XML files are. So cars need these to run, essentially. The XML files tell the game what the car does, what it is, what abilities you may give it, what colours you may give it, what sounds you may give it, so forth and so forth. This is where I copy them and then paste them into another folder where I actually do fiddle about with the cars. I have this folder open here to fiddle. Whenever I download a car or extract a car from another game, it immediately goes here in case I want to screw with its XML file that it has come with it. I don't have to, but I can. If it's a car that doesn't have an XML file because it's not made with mod loader in mind, I will extract an XML file from here, place it in this folder, and fiddle with the XML file and so forth and so forth. You know, it's basically, think of a garage. It's basically a garage for cars in folder form, really. You know, and you're messing with the XML file and all that. Anyway, enough chatter. Let's download a car. We're going to need one. So, a good site to get them from is this website here. NVR Resources. This is one of Almost's websites. As you can see there, he's even got some cars of his own, which is pretty nifty. Lots of other people have lots of other cars, different types. And you can download cars from various other sites, with or without mod loader in mind. I'm not going to link you to like all the possible sites you can get vehicles from. You can just browse the internet and look for them yourselves. It's not that hard to find. See, even GTA forums has them, and you know, GTA gaming, GTA garage has them, and so forth. Has lots of cars. Anyway, first off, we're going to download a car with the mod in mind. So you're thinking, which car should we have? Oh, what car? Impala. What does that look like? Whoop. Ah, that looks like a nice car. I think I'll nab it, you're thinking, so close that. Let's nab it. Link. Download mod. Now, you can download this wherever you want, but like I say, I always download them to here. Guess I need to edit them, so I've already been experimenting and messing around with cars. So, you go to Fiddle, and in the RAR file, you extract it out of the RAR file and you get another folder and you get a 7-zip folder. Now all the cars need to be packaged in a 7-zip folder, otherwise the mod won't recognize them. So this RAR file, useless. You go in here and you can just put this in vehicles and it will work straight away, but I'm going to show you what comes with cars that are packaged with the mod, just so you got an idea of what to do when a car doesn't have any of these files. So there you go, you've got the XML file, you've got a texture file, a model file, and a collision file. Now these are the four key ingredients needed for the 7-zip file. As you can see, the XML just tells the game what the car is. This is essentially the car's blueprints, kinda, sorta, a bit. There's its colour scheme, there's its AI data, who drives it, you know, poor people, rich people, fancy executive corporate people, or even gangs and police and whatnot. Wheel sizes. Now, wheel sizes is an important thing, and we'll cover those in another video. And, you know, yeah, you got name there, Impaler, you can call it whatever you want. And this is what it's called in-game, this is what the car is called in-game. So if I call it Impaler, like, car, simple, or, because it looks like a Sabre, I'll call it a Sabre. It will show up in the game as Sabre. I'm going to do that just as an example to show you, Sabre. And, oh, close up too early there. But yeah, there's handling data, and there's lots of other funky stuff. Sounds, audio. You can edit all these from here, or you can edit them on the resource site. And I'll go through some of that in another video, because it's a bit complicated and complexy. So I've just edited the XML file. If I wanted to, I could place that straight in the game, but because I've edited it and called it Impala Sabre, I'll put it in my own 7-zip folder at archive. Let's call it Impala Sabre. I just want it to be more noticeable in the game, just so as you can see it. Impala Sabre. Copy. Go to your directory. Go to vehicles, and as you can see, I've got loads of cars. I've got cars from real life, I've got cars from San Andreas, I've got cars from Xbox, I've got cars from GTA 3, I've got beta cars. All of these have been downloaded except for the San Andreas cars. I extracted these out of San Andreas myself, and I will be showing you how to do that in case you ever want to do that as well. So there you go, there's the Impala, however you pronounce that bloody car name. And yeah, All you do is load up the game from now on. So I'm going to pause the recording and then resume it when I am in the game world. Because I was trying to do this tutorial with Camtasia earlier and it absolutely died. It didn't like running in the least bit, you know, with the loading screen, so I had to keep pausing it, and eventually the thing just couldn't handle recording for some reason whatsoever. So I'm using Hypercam. And yeah, so if I pause the recording and then I'll show you in game later. And yes, we have the game loaded now in windowed mode, another mod loader feature. It is controlled with one of the global XMLs. We'll discover which one at another time. So to spawn the vehicle, you're going to want to go up to the menu up here. Spawn vehicle, weapons, windows, output. So let's go to spawn vehicle. And what did I call it? I called it the Impaler Sabre. So let's have a look for that. Impaler Sabre. Impaler Sabre. Where are you? Where are you? Impaler Sabre. Then we go to resume and the car will spawn right in front of you. This is the car that we had just downloaded. And it's a good car, it functions like a proper car. Yes, I've turned the radio off, by the way. It says it doesn't interrupt video. And this, there it is. Can be damaged like a car usually is. Yeah, shoot it up proper gangster style with the bullet holes. Another mod loader feature, by the way. That's what that bullet hole PNG was. And yeah, we have installed our first car. This car's quite cool. I think I might actually keep it. I don't actually have this car already in the game. So yeah, that's it. And if I spawn another one, it will be a different colour because of the call files in the XML. So yeah. That is how you install cars packaged for the mod. Next up, I'll show you how to package cars that are not for the mod. They will still work if you know how to get them to. So yeah, until then, bye-bye. I'm going to have to stop recording with this program and then load up Hypercam. I've decided to make it easier for me to record the game with Fastone and record the menus and my desktop and all that with Hypercam. So yeah. And here we are about to install a car that is not packaged for the mod. In other words, a car that was available for download before this mod existed and it hasn't been converted, or a car that just hasn't been made with it in mind. I've chosen a car. I've chosen a Chevrolet Bel Air convertible. So we'll download that to the Fiddle folder. I chose this car because it's a nice car and because I already have this car in my game. Yeah, it's kind of showing off how you can have copies of the same car, which is good for in case you want one car to have different handling to another car, but you want the car to be the same shape. Or you can have one version that has special abilities, one version that doesn't have special abilities, and so forth and so forth. Neither of them are going to have special abilities, at least not yet anyway. We're just gonna show you how to put them in the game. So we go in and we find the TXT and DFF files. There we go. Let's put them in the main folder and we delete them. We don't need anything in that mod folder. We just need the Virgo TXT and DFF. Doesn't matter what they're called, because we know from downloading that the textures and the models are in the shape of a Bel Air convertible. And yeah, it has two of the four files needed. So the first file we're going to get is the collision file. So we'll go to the car editor. There will be a download to this as well. We want to load. We want to load the collision file for Grand Theft Auto Vice City. So you go into its directory, vehicles call, and it says Virgo, but we don't want the Virgo. It looks more, the shape and size looks more like an Oceanic, I think. A nice classic car. So we go to Oceanic. Oh, there we go. Export. Then you tell it to export where the DFF. And TXT files are. I'll just fiddle with cars to fiddle. Call it what you want, but I'll call it Oceanic. Purely for the purposes that I know what collision files I'm using for what kind of cars. So we close that now. Now it has three of the files needed. Now we're going to go to the XML files. Now every car needs an XML. Every car needs an XML. That's without saying. Like I already said, it's basically the brains and the guts, the body of the car. And all that. So let's go for Oceanic. Now copying this folder up this file into this folder and then packaging it in a 7-zip will have the color scheme of the Oceanic and the name of the Oceanic. To change this we need to just highlight it and call it whatever car we've just downloaded. So we'll go call it 57 Bell example. Ooh, I already have a properly named Bel Air convertible, so we just want to call it example for now so we can recognize it. And AI data who drives it, like I've already gone over. We're not going to touch the car colors. We're going to give it the scheme after Oceanic. Because we just want to get the car in the game just to prove that it can get into the game. 7-zip, add to archive, we'll call it 57 example. Copy the vehicle folder, paste, there it is, 57 example. And then we go and load up the game. So I'll pause this and then get out Firestone or whatever it was called. Faststone, and yeah, be back with you. Okay, so we're back in game. And we have our menu in the top left corner. And we're in the pause menu. Where we need to spawn the car that we've just placed into the game. I think it's here. Yep. 57 Bell example. There we go. I already have this car in the game, I shall show you this now. Where is it? First menu. This is how I've named it properly for proper gameplay. You know, where I don't spawn cars. Spawning them is good to see if they actually work or not. Anyway, there it is, Bel Air, no roof. In other words, convertible. And there we go, identical. Except for colours, although they do share the same colour scheme. And have you noticed the wheels are smaller in the car we've just placed into the game? They share the exact same XML file, but the reason why the wheels are different is because in the XML file for this one, I edited the wheel size and made the wheels a bit bigger. I've left the wheel size untouched on this one. Malware, screw you. There we go, this is the example one. But they are still essentially the same car. It's just a little example of how you can use the same XML for different copies of cars if you want something to differ. So yeah, none of them have any special abilities, but I could give special abilities to one and not the other, but I'm not doing that now. But that's just a quick little glimpse, you know, how each car could share the same XML but with differing properties, which results in two different cars, or one that could have completely different XML should I choose to do so. So yeah, the next one I'll put in the game will be a car from San Andreas, and I have a car in mind for this one. I shall extract the tornado and place it into this game. So yeah, stick around for that, and I shall stop the recording now and then resume my hypercam business. Okay, so I'm in the directory of Vice City, and I'll load up the two fiddle folder. Get rid of that. Now this part, this example will be telling you how to get a car from San Andreas into Vice City without downloading anything aside from tools, collision editor and IMG tool. First off, we're going to need IMG tool. So we load up IMG tool new, load it up, and open. Open the GTA3.img of the San Andreas directory in the models folder. Open it up. Now we said we're going to do the tornado car, so we've got to find tornado. See, I've already done this before. Find next, and you'll see tornado txt. We want to extract that to fiddle. Find next. DFF, the model file, we want to extract that and just close that. And in the two fiddle folder we have half the car already. We're going to need another collision file, so we've got the call editor, open up. The tornado, I'll go for Oceanic again, they're roughly the same shape. So we want to load vehicles car. Oceanic again. Of course you can use any of these that you like. I'm just making sense by going for the collision file that's closest to the car that I've just, you know, extracted. Where do I extract it to again? Mods for Vice City, there we go. Maxo's vehicle loader, folder to fiddle with cars, to fiddle. Let's call it Oceanic again. Oceanic. Save. And now we have 3/4 of the mod already. Three quarters of the files needed. So we got to XML files again. How do we want it to handle? What properties do we want to give it? Let's go for Oceanic again, because, you know, similar cars. Copy. Of course you can use any of these you want, any of them, doesn't matter, but depending on how you want the car to handle, it's wise to make a decision on what to get. So Oceanic, let's open that up. We do not want the car to be called an Oceanic because it's not an Oceanic. We'll call it Tornado SA example again. We'll leave the wheels and the colour scheme and the class files as default for now. And then we'll pop this into an archive. We'll call it... I can't call it SA Tornado. I already have my proper one called that. So we'll just call it Tornado SA. Ooh. Backwards this time. Copy that. Go to the vehicles folder, we paste it. Tornado SA. There is my real one up there. And we'll load up the game and we'll see how it runs in the game. And we're back in the game. So let's spawn in our little tornado car. I called it, started off with tornado, didn't it? See, there's all my San Andreas cars to spawn. Oh, pardon me, I am full of gas. And here is our, sorry. And here is our car that we've just made, Tornado SA EX example. So we want to spawn that in. Pop it down. There it is. It's currently, I've done it identical to the Tornado that I'm really using for gameplay. Tornado SA is the real one. I say real one. I've given this one a different XML file, again, to show you that you can have different XML files for the same cars. This one has the Voodoo's XML file, and the reason why it's different colours from the Voodoo is because I transported the colours from the Oceanic to the Voodoo XML. As simple as that. And we'll be doing stuff like this in another video. So yeah, this is the car we've just done. So yeah, we have one more car to do, and that is downloading a car meant for San Andreas, but putting it in Vice City. It has generally the same principles, but we'll do it anyway, just as a proof of concept. So yeah, another cutaway. And now it's time to download the car. I've chosen this car, this Plymouth. I'll go for this one because it looks cool. And as you can see, no Vice City download, just the San Andreas download. So you download it, pop it in the two fiddle folder, nicely done. Then we extract. And as you can see, it has the DFF and texture files that we need, so we can delete everything. We know what the car looks like. Don't need no readme either. We can just delete that. So there, we've got half the mod again already. And you know, I just want to point out though, that I forgot to mention before, is that some cars that you download may already come with their own collision file. If they do, you do not need to open up collision editor. Just wanted to point that out to you, because some of them do have their own collision files, especially if they're like a fancily wildly differently shaped car. You know, if you download like a flyable spaceship, it might come with its own collision file, for example. Anyway, I don't need that, but we do need the collision file editor. We want to load this up again. It's the Sabre. So, but it looks like it's the Sabre Turbo. Rather than, let's see, Sabre Turbo. Might as well get that, even though they're essentially the same. Because it's got the engine through the bonnet, that's why. Mods for Vice City. Vehicle loader, fiddle, Sabre, enter, save, and close that. And of course we need to get the XML files again. And because I like to have files closest resembling the car I've just downloaded, we'll go for Sabre Turbo, two fiddle. Sabre Turbo. We'll call it P Cuda, Plymouth Cuda, or Cuda. I don't know how to pronounce that. I really don't. And as you notice, the Sabre only comes in one colour, Sabre Turbo. But that doesn't matter. We're just getting the Cuda into the game. No, I didn't want to enlarge that. What did I enlarge that for? So, 7-zip it. Cuda. Thought I would capitalize it to make it stand out more, you know. Then we place that into the vehicles directory. And we'll load up the game and we should see whether or not it worked. And we are in the game once more. So we shall spawn our little Cuda. And of course, you have to look through the menus to see where it is. P Cuda. That's what we named it. And there it is. Spawned perfectly. Even though it was supposed to be for San Andreas. So yeah. I just want to point out though that some cars you download from San Andreas, at least in my experience, they still look wrong. These are cars that you download, not extract. Like, say if somebody made a car for San Andreas. Sometimes it looks a bit off, but that was in a different version of the mod, so maybe that's fixed by now. But let's just hope it is. Anyway, they still worked. They still drove around. And here we go. It's a Sabre Turbo. And let's drive around a bit to see some other variety of cars. Let's see, we've got a Beta police car, we've got a 50s car, convertible, we've got the Bel Air again there. Got a Dacia, I think that one's a Dacia. And a new fancy police car. Ooh, from San Andreas also. And no, this isn't the Tornado, this is the real life counterpart. Drive it off there. So yeah. That's it for installing basic cars into the game, and yeah. That's it, that's all I can say. The next video will cover emergency vehicles, like police cars and ambulances and things like that, and taxis, to show how they work alongside their proper in-game counterparts, which they thankfully do not replace. So yeah, stay tuned for that. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, and yeah, it's a very good mod and I really urge most people to get it. So until the next video, bye bye. I'm moving, I'm running, I'm exercising.